Hi, Lloyd here again with some important advice. And the advice is this: play the what if game with Excel to deepen your understanding of statistics. I bring this up now because we are at that point of the course where we are just beginning to learn some of the most fundamental principles of statistics. And I think every extra minute you spend right now to really understand what's going on will be returned to you a hundredfold in the weeks, months, and years to come. The great thing about a spreadsheet is that you can play the what if game. That is, what would happen if I change the raw scores in different ways? What will happen to the standard deviation if I increase this number or decrease that number? Will the standard deviation of z-scores always really be 1? And so on. So the point of this short video is not to teach you anything new, but instead to convince you to take some time now to play with the ideas you've just learned. I suggest you do the following. First, be sure you've saved your spreadsheet one more time. Next, let's save it again, but with a new name. I'll go to Save As, and I suggest we simply save it with the same name, but with hyphen sandbox, because in a sandbox we play, we experiment, we do things that we don't really expect to keep. We're just using it as a sandbox to try things out. All right, let me save that. Now I'll just demonstrate a few ideas. And for example, I wonder really if this z score, like the sum of the z scores and the standard deviation of the z scores, will really change if I change the scores. So if I just go to the first student score, and I'm going to put in something a little crazy. I'm going to put in 10,000. Now I saw a lot of big changes here. The standard deviation, for example, has really jumped. I have a lot more variability in there right now. But notice that the sum of the z-scores is still 0, and the standard deviation of the z-scores is still 1. Now again, if I keep putting in 10,000, you can just watch how the standard deviation changes and now it's starting to go down. And if I put in another 10,000, whoa, what just happened? Well, first of all, notice that all the scores are the same. There is no variation. Therefore, it makes total sense that the standard deviation would be 0. Well, what happened over here with the Z column? What's going on here? Well, let's take a look at the very first entry there in the Z column. And there's our formula up here. Now, if I just do a click on it, you will see what other cells are involved. Well, C11, well, that's a 0, and we're dividing by the standard deviation, which is in D26, and that's a 0 also. Well, you might know or remember that it is not allowed to divide by 0. Let me hit that cancel there, and you can see the little exclamation mark, and it gives me this explanation that yes, the formula or function used by is dividing by 0 or empty cells. Dividing by 0 is not allowed. It is referred to by mathematicians as undefined. I've always thought that was a bit of a cop-out by mathematicians. They don't have a definition for it, so they define it as undefined. So in each of these cases, we are dividing by 0. That is the problem. Now, if I come back over to, let's just go to student J, and I'm going to change this to 10,001, everything is better now because we are no longer dividing by 0. Of course, the standard deviation is very, very small. That's it. I'll stop there. I was just trying to make an important point, and I hope you take my advice seriously to take, again, a few minutes as you are learning these different techniques, these different concepts, these different principles, and take full advantage of Excel to play the what-if game in order to more fully understand what is going on. So I hope you'll play the what if game very often in the remaining time we have in the course. Just remember to save your spreadsheet file first so that you have the values as I have shown them in the videos, and then save it again with a word like sandbox or some other word like that to let you know that this is a file that you are allowed to play with and you can make changes and you really are not worrying about what happens inside that file. Until next time.